Leaves are falling all around. It's time I was on my way.
I mean, are we gonna constantly fork because we're not getting the things we want or the upgrades as quickly or even as soundly as we like? Are we gonna keep forcing the issue and keep forking Bitcoin over and over? Will that break Bitcoin in itself? Will that break the system? Because I can see this being very manipulated. I can see a lot of attack vectors happening. Right now with Bitcoin Cash, you have miners mining on and off, and there's been some malicious mining, if you will, trying to prevent the difficulty of the mining percentage on Bitcoin Cash happening, going down. I can see that happening with SegWit 2x, or even the Bitcoin Legacy Chain, with them not having as much hashing power, and some attack vectors happening there, with the security and the amount of blocks being discovered not having happening at the clip or the pace that they should, especially considering how even with the hashing power should leave, even a small percentage, whether it be 5 or even 10%, were to leave off the legacy chain, they'll still be have such a high difficulty rating that it will cause blocks not to come as fast. And considering that the meme pool is filling up, the fees have gone up since they almost getting close to SegWit activation, they have gone up significantly. I've seen some crazy numbers where people are sending small amounts of Bitcoin and are paying twice the value of the Bitcoin in itself, whether deliberately or by mistake. I don't know how that will do for Bitcoin in itself if that continues forward. One of the reasons why Bitcoin Cash forked off was because of the fee issue. One of the reasons why 2 megabyte has been pushed so hard is because of the fee issue. It's just, there's other things that need to be incorporated and added into the Bitcoin protocol, like confidential transactions. There's the mumbo-wumbo proposal. There's privacy concerns. There's Lightning Network. There's other things that can help bring Bitcoin further into a stronger position in the financial market. They'll help it grow and build up. But if we continue to fork off because we're not getting the things that we want or need, or things are not developing fast enough, I don't know what that will do for Bitcoin if we keep building other chains, forking off of Bitcoin Core consistently or constantly. It's almost kind of like, Harry Potter with the Horcrux that Voldemort did, splitting your soul here into like different fragments and diminishing the whole. And that's not good for Bitcoin in itself. I mean, it's good for the short term if you are a holder or you have some Bitcoin in there and you're able to spend, on 3 different chains, but for the long term, it's just bad. It's bad overall in general. And as a community, we really need to have a very strong and more open discussion about this. I mean, I know the discussions are going on, but this seems to be very toxic, very vitriol. We need to have more sound, more sincere discussion about the direction of Bitcoin, the direction of the cryptocurrency space, where we want to go in the space, what we need to do, what protocols need to be put in place, how we have to come to a better sense of consensus, if you will. I'm just not really honestly sure what this all means. I mean, it's because it's just such a rapidly developing issue, and things change almost on a daily basis. And it's really coming down to the point of put up and shut up. And as soon as code comes out, as soon as things are put out, as soon as BIPs, I think BIPs is what Bitcoin Core is, and BTC, I think I called them BOPs, come out, then we're really going to see just exactly, because I don't think it's a game of chicken now. I think it's a game of this is happening, this is going to occur. there is going to be a split, there's going to be a divide. And you know, I just wish we could do better about it, you know, gain more consensus and not have another split. I think with Bitcoin Cash being in existence, you have the lower transaction fees, you have the higher mega blocks, if you will. I'm just not sure exactly if Bitcoin Core can continue to hold its position about being against hard forks when there needs to be so much done with the protocol, the upgrades, if you will, because it's losing traction to other coins like Ethereum, with the smart contracts and the values. I'm not sure if there's going to be a flippening, if you will, but there's been a lot of money pumping to Ethereum. You now have NEO, which is, you know, the Chinese version of Ethereum. You have a lot of coins and, you know, Ripple and things of that nature that are challenging Bitcoin supremacy. They really are. I know there was a dip in the altcoin market as people were trying to, because the value of Bitcoin went up, trying to obtain as much Bitcoin as they could. But the supremacy, the utility of Bitcoin is being challenged. Now that Monero and Zcash are gaining some significant traction, as far as not only value, but usage, if you will, because of the privacy factor, Dash, Litecoin, things of that nature. Yeah, perhaps, you know, maybe Bitcoin Core needs to sit down, have a nice little confab, and develop a new roadmap of what endpoints or end goals that need to be met, when they're going to launch them, and maybe that will be a very sound and counterpoint to the current roadmap, because as it stands right now, I don't think the current Bitcoin protocol roadmap that is out there really is fundamentally addressing all the issues that people have with the protocol, all the things they want to develop. And given the fact that it's taken so long for Segwit to activate, and the Lightning Network hasn't even been put on the tablet and when that's going to be added on, I think it would be important for Bitcoin Core, if they want to challenge the fact that we don't need a hard fork, to bring forth a roadmap to address the issues that people have, or when these things are going to be developed, the code that they've already developed or produced, and when it's going to be added on, that maybe more and more people would be on the side of Bitcoin Core. I'm fundamentally not sure if that's going to happen or if that's going to even make any kind of difference, because it seems both sides are pretty entrenched. And with a third coin come into existence, I just, again, a bad precedent may have been set with Bitcoin Cash, even though it might have been necessary, but to continue forking off of Bitcoin over and over again, I just don't think it will be good for the space. You might as well just kind of develop your own coin at that point, really. I understand, you know, economically, if you want to have the hashing power and the economic value they inherently have with having Bitcoin Core, Bitcoin, as it have already done the work, you know, 8, 9 years or 10 years or whenever that fork will occur. Yeah, I can understand you want to have like the cheat code, if you will. But fundamentally, economically, and just socially and politically and all the illogies, if you will, I don't think it will bode well for Bitcoin for this to continue to happen. So that's it. Those are my thoughts. I just wanted to share, you know, considering that this news has just come out. I know there's been other news about, you know, with the hardware wallets and those vulnerabilities. I think I'm going to save that for News and Inside podcast, but that's it for now, and thank you for listening, and to the moon.